Hey, it's Fran again in the lab with an update to my Apollo comm system video I did a little while ago. In that video, I used Peach Fuzz as a preamp to be able to equalize the impedance issues I was having with the comm set. Turns out that the microphone in the comm headset is low impedance, which makes sense because with low impedance systems, you can have a great deal of travel between the microphone and the amplifier, as opposed to high impedance systems where you end up getting a noise and a lot of high frequency cutoff very quickly just from the resistance of the wiring and such. But anyway, I bought an impedance adapter, which I decided I was going to discombobulate to be able to put the transformer into the line to make it easy for me to carry aboard by flight. And so, yeah, just taking it apart reveals the tiny little transformer. Even though this was set up to be equalized to non-equalized, it's very easy. I just combined the low and the ground side of the equalized part of the transformer. Just use the high and the low and ground as the other side. And this looks like it's just going to be very straightforward. It was really just a matter of taking out the old plug, wiring in the transformer, and giving it a little test. All right, this is a new Zoom H6 that I got just for the flight. It's a 6-channel audio recorder. It's got dual condensers for actual live room sound, and then 4 other inputs. I'm going to have a lavalier on here just as a redundancy, and one for the comm mic. And now that I've gotten the transformer in here to get the correct impedance matching, I'm going to put that in channel 1. And I put the right angle because this recorder is going to be in my pocket. So it's going to be in my pocket, and the right angle jacks, I can just come out of the pocket, and with this microphone will be sticking out of the pocket. And I might have to rig a right angle here, but I don't know. I got plenty of room for that. But I certainly didn't have room for the for all of this to be sticking out at a 90-degree angle plus a jack and converter and all that blah blah blah. So, all right. So let's see here. Get the comm set up. And I'm going to seal all this and insulate it acoustically. The microphone here. Okay. Record one. All right. Record.
Yeah, I've got to insulate this a little bit. Okay. Well, yeah, it's just the picking up the lights a little bit. There you go. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Check. 1, 2. That's at 9, 10. Okay. There we go. We got comms. And yeah, I think once I get this insulated, I'm going to put some foil around it and ground it. And yeah, you can feel it there. But it seems like the impedance matching problem is done. Seems to work just fine. All right, let's just wrap this up, insulate it, and I think we'll be good to go.
Right. So I've got I use this now. I just stopped using electrical tape a long time ago, but the silicone tape, it sticks to itself permanently, and it's also waterproof. So you just peel it off from its backing, and then what I'm going to do is basically create the beginnings of an insulation just by rolling this around this, and I'm gonna kind of just go like this, right? I'm going to encase this in foil and then ground the foil and wrap it up in silicone. This adhesive copper foil is pretty good stuff, because I'm going to actually solder it to one side once I get it wrapped around. All tricky here. I'm able to do this because the transformer is already electrically insulated. So I really just have to build a little Faraday cage for it. And the great thing about the foil is you can crunch it up, you know, and just kind of make it fit. Alright. I'm gonna solder this right here. Alright. And now, just to proof it, I'm gonna wrap the rest of this in silicone. Great thing about the silicone too is you can stretch it, make it tight, and it'll make a nice even seal. So much better than the old adhesive electrical tape. Back it up on itself. Alright, strong. More piece here. Put this in half. Alright. There we go. Nice and strong. It's really sturdy. All right, let's try this again with the insulation on it. It should work out okay. It's hooked up to the glasses. Right. Earpiece.
Check one. All right. Sounds really clear in the earpiece, no buzzing, even with a fluorescent light nearby. So yeah, it looks like we got a good noise floor. Very low noise floor, so. Alright. Yeah, it's picking up a little of the fluorescent, but if I turn off the fluorescent light. Yeah, okay. Alright. Well, this'll do. I have to put a right angle connector on this one too. Probably, but not too bad, not too shabby. Not too bad, not too shabby. All right. Looks like we're good to go. All right. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to everybody on the Patreon making all these videos possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Everyone on the Patreon. And, I'll see you in 0G. But you know we'll be doing stuff in the lab before then, so anyway. Alright, well, Fran Lab is at Stable 1. This is Fran, signing off.
In the lab. That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. My lab, it's where I work. Bench again.
time, Fran.